The bee is covered in pollen. Look at how efficiently the bee is pollinating the whole flower. Let's see. Ladybird facing downwards. Beautiful flowers going off. And
yes, I'll come.
another exotic beauty out here, frangipanis. These are branches for last year, so we just planted them in pots, even though the branches are flowering and leafing. They're just 6 months old, so that's something nice to look at. Same with this one, it needs to be watered today. It's looking quite dry. There's a bit of a ginger there, if you can look. Yeah, ginger is not doing well in this side. It gets a lot of sun. I reckon ginger needs a lot of shed and warmth, a lot of fertile soil and not water. But frangipani here on the other hand, look at them, they're already flowering. Oh, the sweetness, the fragrance of the flower it produces is blindingly beautiful. Look at them. Oh, the fragrance they create. There's a few other plants that we have managed to pot last season. The plant was growing too big, so I just snapped off some branches and just popped them in water. So here comes our they look a bit sad as well. They need to be watered today. They are a guava plant that I planted a couple of years ago. They are doing truly well. The amount of fruit it's in this plant and the size the plant is, it's humongous. All so look at all the flowers and the fruits it's bearing. Hopefully we can feed it enough to have those fruits stay on the tree and feed us for many months. These are our wicking beds. Basically they are IBC drums that have been cut into two halves. It's a rough and tough job by me. I've just used the angle grinder, cut it into two halves. It does have a small overflow valve there. You can see down here, that's an overflow valve. Otherwise, this is a pot of diversities. Each pallet contains basil, broccoli, a lot of mint. It's really happy mint. We had a lot of spring onion. So here are the seeds of the birds of the spring onions. I'm going to collect them now because I'm losing a lot. These are like a whole harvest birds. It's been a bit busy. Here is our cucumber. It's just doing very well. The cucumber is very happy. This is a bit of dill growing. We wanted them for leaves, so hopefully we'll harvest one of them. There's as cross plantation, we have marigold going on there. If you can see, there's a flower popping up from there. That's your marigold, and the next door it's basil here. So the first thing I tried growing here was basil. Nothing came up, so I've tried multiple things on it. So right now cucumber is thriving, fighting its way out. Here in this pod we have chives. Chives go very well in dumplings. And I tried planting peas here. They didn't do well. And if you can, there is a pod there on the corner. just to pour there. You can see there, but yeah, it's not doing pretty well. It just threw it away. So as you know, I've just collected some let me show you the biggest pot, best I have here. Let me just see if this beat up with okay, that was spring onion. I'll just bottle around it. So what we have encountered here is a green caterpillar. Can you see it there on top of the leaf? So this turns, they turn into white caterpillars, sorry, white butterflies. They are quite pretty when they're butterflies, but they are vicious. They go through your greens. So there's two ways of getting rid of them. You can spray them or you can just pick them. So picking them is not that hard. Just pick them like anything. They just they're not prickly or itchy as caterpillars, so you can step on them and squash them. I rather use them as protein for my chickens. Oh, they enjoy it. They enjoy it thoroughly. And I think there's a pot of eggs I've encountered. So that's a pot of egg. There should be a lot of this green stuff in here then. Oh, there's another one. Okay, right there. Encounter two. Picking it off. Two off. There should be more. They are on top and under the leaves as well. So they work both ways. Tend to kill them by feeding it to my chooks. So thank you. You'll be thoroughly enjoyed. Look at the condition here. Same here. It's been ripped apart. So where are this beautiful? Oh, I can see one right there. Can focus it there. See? Okay. Three. So let's go for. There should be one more here though. Where it is. Oh, yep. No. Yeah, identified one more. Where we are. Okay. So there we go. One, two, three, and so this is to be zoomed. So four of them there, they'll make a handsome snack for my thing. And here we go. This is our, I don't want the chili, which is doing well. It's producing a bit of red chili there, a bit of eggplants. So yeah, so this is part of my aquaculture. They are not connected yet as a system. So hopefully as this system completes, the wicking bed would be connected to two water tanks, front and back, one acting as a reservoir and next acting as the fish pond. So yeah, let's hope we can work on the projects as it comes along.